I'm often asked about using plywood for making a bandsaw frame. I always advise against it because half the grain is in the wrong direction, so it won't be as strong or as stiff.
But how much weaker is it? So I'll use my joint strength tester to test a whole bunch of pieces of plywood, particle board, OSB, MDF, and solid wood in comparison. Each of my samples is 5 centimeters wide, and the supports here are 15 centimeters apart, or 2 inches and 6 inches. First test, a 15.2 millimeter piece of plywood along the long grain. Pretty good. It's failing here. 265 kilograms. Next up, a slightly thinner piece of solid pine. But I had programmed the machine to only go to 300 kilograms and then back off, just to protect it physically. So I bumped that limit up to 350.
Uh-oh. And the gears come off the motor. Okay, that's good and broke.
This didn't actually break across all the way because I'm only applying force in one spot here. So I need to put this thing on top of my pusher to spread it out a bit more.
300. Okay, that exceeded the maximum force. So this piece is half the width because my tester isn't strong enough.
This was marginally thinner and half the width of the plywood, but almost the same failure strength. Now that plywood has 3 thick layers along the length of it. Let's test it in the other direction. 158 versus 265, not a bad showing for cross grain. Let's try some solid wood cross grain. Even though this was 1/3 thicker than this and half the width, its breaking force was less than 1/5, so cross grain, this is less than 1/10 the strength of this stuff long grain. Next test, some Baltic birch plywood. That maxed out 350 kilograms that my thing applies. That's close to 800 pounds. So I bumped up the maximum allowable force again, this time to 380 kilograms. That's over 800 pounds.
Oh, needs a bit of help. The motor started to skip at those forces. Okay, we broke it.
Even though this Baltic birch is a fair bit thinner than this stuff, it failed at a much higher force. It should have failed at half of this force if it was by thickness and such the same strength as this. I like to use this stuff because it's got thin plies and it looks a bit like Baltic birch, but not the same quality. Overlapping plies here, for example, and also probably poplar instead of birch. This was about the same strength as these pieces of plywood, even though it's actually about 2 millimeters thicker. I took all my fail numbers and thicknesses for the samples so far and worked out how strong those would have been if they had been 1/2 inch thick. And that's based on the assumption that the same piece of wood twice as thick would be 4 times as strong, which is also why wood oriented this way, if you push down, is much stronger than flat like this. So this is the 5-ply relatively thick stuff. This is some thin ply plywood, same relative strength. Then this is Baltic birch, and this is solid pine. So you can see the Baltic birch and the solid pine are about the same, Baltic birch being a bit stronger, whereas these ones are 1/2 the strength of solid wood. And then these two are cross-grain tests, and you can see that contributes hardly anything.
So as expected, plywood is 1/2 as strong because 1/2 the grain is in the wrong direction. The Baltic birch is strong because the birch itself is just a stronger wood.
And I said the birch is a stronger wood. Well, let's test some birch. Got 3 samples of birch here of different dimensions, and adjusting for the dimensions, they all came out very consistently, and putting those on my graph, this is the solid birch, which is stronger than the Baltic birch, but not twice as strong. But my understanding is that Baltic birch is actually a particularly good sort of birch, which is why it comes from the Baltics. But now let's try the particle board, OSB, and MDF. I plugged in the numbers for particle board, MDF, and OSB, and this is what it looks like on my chart adjusted for size. The particle board is maybe a third to a quarter the strength on average of the plywoods, so quite weak as expected. The MDF did better, half as strong as my weakest plywood samples, and then the OSB actually has an orientation, so across the grain the tests were quite weak. Along the grain, this is actually quite comparable with the plywoods, although one of my long grain OSB pieces failed relatively weakly.
So in summary, particle board is just crap for strength. It's maybe a third to a quarter strength of plywood. MDF is better, possibly half the strength of plywood. OSB, as long as it's along the grain, is quite comparable to plywood most of the time, but it's inconsistent. But across the grain, it's only half as strong as plywood.